This is part three of solving quadratic equations using the quadratic formula. And we solve this quadratic equation using the quadratic formula, and then we also solve it by completing the square. This is part three, and we're going to continue solving quadratic equations using the quadratic formula. So here's an example, 1/6 x squared plus x plus 1/3 equals 0. This is in standard form, and you could say, well, a is 1/6, b is 1, and c is 1/3. But when you plug this into the quadratic formula, it gets pretty complicated looking. You're going to have some complex fractions. So there's an easier way to deal with this one. Since it's an equation, you can multiply both sides by the least common denominator to eliminate the fractions. So if you want for fun, you can go ahead and plug in these values of a, b, and c into the quadratic formula and check that you're going to get the same answer as the way I'm going to do it, which is multiply both sides of the equation by 6, the least common denominator. So if I multiply the terms on both sides of the equation by 6. So I have 6 times 1/6 x squared plus 6 times x plus 6 times 1/3 equals 6 times 0. I've multiplied both sides of the equation by 6, the least common denominator, to eliminate fractions. And when I do this, I get a much easier problem. All right, now, you can't factor this, by the way. We're practicing using the quadratic formula, but you wouldn't be able to solve this by factoring. You could solve this by completing the square. And in fact, I think this would be an easy one to do because it's got a 1 in front of the x squared, and this middle term is even, so it'll be easy to take half of it. But we're going to go ahead and practice using the quadratic formula. So in this case, a is 1, b is 6, and c is 2. And hopefully you'll agree that's a little bit easier than plugging in 1/6, 1, and 1/3 for the values of a, b, and c. All right, so we're going to plug this into the quadratic formula now. X equals, all right, so if we kind of chunk the whole thing out here, I've got the opposite of b, so opposite of 6, negative b, plus or minus the square root, so plus or minus the square root of b squared. That's 6 squared. You don't have to put a parenthesis around the 6 because it's not negative and it won't make any difference when it's already positive. Minus 4ac. So that's 4 times 1 times 2. All over 2a, 2 times 1. So that's plugging in all the values into the quadratic formula. So we have negative 6 plus or minus. And now inside, underneath the square root, we've got 36 minus 8. All over 2, and 36 minus 8 is 28, so you've got the square root of 28. Now I'm going to write 28 as 4 times 7, because that'll make it easier to simplify. I'm writing it as a perfect square times 7, and we get negative 6 plus or minus. Now you could take out the square root of 4 is 2, so I can take out a 2 and also have the square root of 7 all over 2. Now, you could split it up at this point. There's two ways to simplify this. Whoops. What you could do is factor out a 2 out of the numerator, and that gives you negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 7. All over 2, and now that 2 is a factor, you can cancel, and you're going to get your two answers. One is going to be negative 3 plus square root of 7, and the other is going to be negative 3 minus square root of 7. You could have also taken this step right here, and split the numerator up. So you could put negative 6 over 2 plus or minus 2 square roots of 7 over 2. And then you could just reduce each of these. So it's negative 3 plus or minus square root of 7, which will lead you to the same two solutions, negative 3 plus square roots of 7 And negative 3 minus square root of 7. Okay, and of course, if you were to plug in those fractions, it would be very messy to plug those into the quadratic formula. But if you completely simplified, if you just kept going for it, you should end up with exactly the same two solutions. Now I'm going to take that problem one more time and go ahead and do it by completing the square so you can see that that's actually an easier way. Well, it could be an easier way for some people. So here's the problem again, and this was the solution. We got negative 3 plus radical 7, negative 3 minus radical 7. Let's just do this by completing the square, just so you can see an alternate way to do this. So remember, you put the x squared term and the x term on the left side, the constant on the other side, and you're going to be adding the same number to both sides of the equations. Then we bring down, what's got to be in parentheses? That's got to be x. If it's a plus 6, it's got to be half that, so plus 3. And then 3 squared is what gets added to both sides. So in other words, x squared plus 6x plus 9 factors to x plus 3 squared. And over on the right-hand side, negative 2 plus 9 is 7. And now we take the square root of both sides. And don't forget, when you take the square root of both sides, you have to put plus or minus in front of the number on the right. So it's plus or minus the square root of 7. Last thing is to subtract 3 from both sides. And so, same answer. You would have negative 3 plus square root of 7 and negative 3 minus square root of 7. So you might want to compare that to what happened when we used the quadratic formula, where we had to worry about simplifying at the end. Let's just look up here a little bit. This is what it looked like when we were doing the quadratic formula. So we had a lot of simplification here, and then we had to factor out the 2 and do a little more simplifying to finally get those answers. But you do get the same solution either way. Okay, so you could use the quadratic formula, you could use completing the square, and if you want, you could use the quadratic formula using the fractions of the original quadratic equation I gave you. So what I wanted to illustrate in this problem is that if you do have a quadratic equation with fractions, you could multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator in order to clear the fractions and have easier numbers to plug in for A, B, and C.